for the Lord, oh God. See Vickie and Angie and Debbie. Oh, you mothers and fathers. Teach your children. Teach your children that they must pray. They must pray down.
Lord help us, sister out now.
Come on,
move my every fist.
Come on,
move my every thigh.
Not too
wide, not too deep. Help me get over this.
Come on,
Lord, I wanna.
They said that I was in too deep. They gave up hope and walked away from me. Something about it they could not see. My old mama on her knees.
She prayed for me.
She was praying for me, yeah.
She was praying.
Women say,
Lord help my sister out now.
Sing it with me.
My everything.
Oh Lord.
My everything. Not too wide. Not too deep.
I gotta get over.
Help me get over this.
Come on.
Lord, I wanna.
Sing it, baby. Now I'm a witness and my God has to pray. When all forsake you, he will be right there. People say whatever they may believe. The more they talk, I'm gonna stay on my
stay on my knees.
I'm gonna stay on my knees.
I'm gonna stay on my knees.
Praying with a prayer.
Lord help us.
Just out now.
Come on, move my everything.
Come on, move my everything.
Not too wide.
Not too deep.
Come on, I'm making all of this.
Help me, Lord, I wanna.
For the women of mourning, let them take up a wailing. For death has climbed into our windows, into our doors, and our communities too. Pray for your sons and your daughters, your uncles, your aunts, your grandmamas. Call on God. He will. He's able. He's gonna see you through.
Oh, yeah.
St. Martin, San Juan, St. John, Nassau, and St. Thomas are yours aboard the Eastern Caribbean Cruise with Bishop T.D. and Serena Jakes.
The cruise is an opportunity just to kind of get away from the day-to-day routine, just to have a break from parenting, from work.
I love the water, the peace, the serenity.
Experience 7 exciting days aboard the magnificent Carnival Victory Superliner.
I truly enjoyed meeting Bishop Jakes. That was a highlight for me.
Being able to spend quality time with my husband on our balcony and just enjoying each other.
The gourmet cuisine, insightful sessions with the bishop, and beautiful beaches are found only on this cruise.
You're sharing something, a part of your life, and all of a sudden, you're either being the strength for someone or the encouragement, or they are.
To find out how you can cruise with the bishop November 9th through the 16th, write to us, visit our website, or call 1-800-247-1899 today.
I have a question, Bishop. Right now, I'm going through a period where you know something, I know something is inside of me, and I feel it with everything in me, but I don't see anything. And it's a warfare. I know that I'm in a warfare right now, in a spiritual warfare. And my question is how do you deal with that? Hold on to your faith, no matter what it looks like. And you keep on to that feeling that you feel inside of you, that something is getting ready to break, something is getting ready to explode. How do you hold on to that?
You know, I'm going to jump on that, and then I'm going to just open it up to whoever. As a man, one of the most amazing things I find about women is how intuitive you are. Mm-hmm. that God puts instincts within you that defy reasoning, mm-hmm. that a woman can sense more than she has tangible evidence for. Mm-hmm. She just knows it. She doesn't know how she knows it. She just knows, don't trust him. Don't try. I'm telling you right now, you're going to be sorry. You know? And I found in a lot of cases, you're really right. And to trust the voice within more than you trust the trouble without.
Yes.
That in fact, there is something about to birth in your life. And one of the things that as we get ready to travel and we're going around the country challenging women, we're calling it the God's Leading Lady Conference. What we're trying to do is to help prepare them mm-hmm. to unearth that thing that's caught in the womb.
Yes.
I think it's 2 Kings 19:3 says, this is a day of rebuke and of trouble. For the children have come to birth and there is no strength to deliver. There are many, many women who have a dream stuck in their womb, and they just need a little help to push out the thing that's stuck in the womb. And the children have, your dream has come to birth. It's right in your womb right now. And what we want to do as ministers is to say to you what we would say in a birthing room. They tell you when to push. You have to know this is the moment right now. Your dream is alive and kicking, and birthing is uncomfortable. Birthing a business is uncomfortable. Birthing a career is uncomfortable. And knowing when to push is critical. Mm-hmm. If you push too soon, your labor's in vain. If you mm-hmm. push too late, you miss the opportunity. Mm-hmm. The timing of the Lord mm-hmm. is so critical. And I sense through the divine operation of the Holy Ghost that you're coming to a pushing point.
Through
the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you're coming to a place now where you're going to be able to push some things that you've dreamed about earlier and have not been able to push. And the thing that I'm excited about as we go out on the road is sharing with women when to push and how to push to get their dreams out, not just to get so you can get your dance in. We're not talking about getting your dance in. We're talking about getting your dream out, discovering your purpose and getting your destiny out. And that's just something the Lord gave me. Maybe somebody else. Yes, sure.
You need somebody to tell you when to push.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes even you have to help them push.
Right.
I remember naturally when I had Angie, my strength failed. Just mm-hmm. like you said, you don't have the strength mm-hmm. to push. And I was in the delivery room, and I knew to push. Mm-hmm. I had all these other kids.
Right.
But I tried, and I couldn't. And the doctor came and said, I'm going to help you. Let mm-hmm. me know when the next contraction is coming,
mm-hmm.
and I'm going to help you push. And he did.
Mm-hmm.
And through that, Angie came on.
You came into the
so
world.
So sometimes she might need help from the pastor,
mm-hmm.
from the mothers,
mm-hmm.
or from another peer in the church.
Mm-hmm.
We've got to help each other.
That's
We've
right.
got to tangibly help each other in situations where they don't have the strength.
I think it's so critical. One of the mistakes that we make as a people and as a culture is that when one of us receives anything, we often don't take the time to tell others how we did it.
That's right.
And when you say about helping the other person to push, our way of contributing to your deliverance is to share with you what it was like for us, how we came through, and to strengthen. And as we design this leading ladies concept, mm-hmm. the thing that's exciting to me is we want to go back and just sit down and tell them how to push.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get all that done in a sermon.
No.
You know, sometimes a sermon, you're so busy exegeting the text that you don't get down to the very practical, you know, help me push. When did you push? When did you leave the house and start your career? When did you wait and say, this is the time I need to spend with my companion? When did you start investing your money? When did you start going after your dream? Just some very practical things. And I don't want to get in your way, Dr. Cook, because I think you want to...
And also just surrounding yourselves with people who you believe are where you're trying to go.
Yeah,
it's about celebrating and surrounding and sharing our stories. I was sitting next to Debbie, who's going to be a mom, and just started sharing what my pregnancy was like, and encouraging and praying for her to have a healthy delivery.
Mm-hmm.
And it is the sharing of our stories that brings the sisters together and gives encouragement to those. God says he has plans for you to prosper, and I believe that for you.
Amen.
So hold on to that.
Amen. That's so important. Glory to God. This is so necessary because I really do with the unique thing that's different from to me, Woman Thou Art Loose and Leading Ladies is it talks about what you've been loosed for.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Leading Ladies deals with what you've been loosed for. Mm-hmm. And it catches you in the mid process of birthing. Maybe you're going, the Bible says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Maybe you're going up the steps. You can get stuck on the steps.
Mm-hmm.
You can be in between destinations.
Mm-hmm.
And you just need a little shove to get to the next level of life. And we want to provide that shove for you and strengthen you in Jesus' name.
Another thing, Bishop, is that when you think of the birthing process, and if we look at ourselves as a body of Christ, as the midwives,
mm-hmm.
we have to be wise midwives.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes, you know, you look up that birth canal and, you know, maybe that baby might be breached.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, you may look and say, well, that ain't God.
Mm-hmm.
But see, it might be God, but it's just breached. We have to be wise enough to be able to stick our hand in there, to reach in there and turn that baby around so they can come the right way. Because
mm-hmm.
if we're not wise midwives, we can cause the mother, the person who's pregnant, we can cause them to miscarry,
mm-hmm.
you know, or to abort the whole baby.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to be wise midwives while we're in the birthing room.
Right. Right. I feel you. You know what? Let me tell you something. In keeping with this metaphor, and it's very important that you understand that every baby, every business, every ministry, every career, everything, whether you're talking about a natural baby or you're talking about a spiritual baby, an economic baby, a corporate baby, begins with a seed.
Yes.
It starts with a seed. And an idea that God puts in the womb of your mind is so powerful.
Mm.
You prayed and you said, Lord, I want to get out of this neighborhood. And God didn't give you a check. He just gave you an idea.
Mm.
You said, Lord, I want to move from this level of life to the next level of life. And God plants an idea in your head. That idea is a seed.
Mm-hmm.
It's a seed that if you hold on to it and become pregnant by it and don't abort it just because you're having problems with it, just because you don't have the money to fund it, just because the loan didn't come through, if you hold on to that seed and carry it full term,
mm-hmm.
in the fullness of time, you're going to deliver that baby, and God's going to bless you. And I want you to write and tell us how God blessed you to birth that business, that company, that dream, that vision, because you're surrounded by women today who have birthed and are birthing again. Not just natural. We're not talking about having no more kids. Hallelujah. But we are talking about producing the purpose of God in our lives. That's all we can get in today. I'm excited, but you've got to stay tuned tomorrow because we're going deeper and wider and further. Thank you for watching The Potter's Touch.
We need help.
Mm-hmm.
We can offer that help to others. It's all I want to do.
To give some people so much courage, you get discouraged yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You have to keep priorities.
A lot of people will not cheer you on, but you have to work for the applause of heaven.
Right.
And not for the applause of others.
If God has placed the dream in us, then God is obligated to get us there.
Everything I know about managing myself and cutting out that middleman, God taught me.
Right.
But I was willing to allow him to teach me what I needed to know.
It wasn't that we were the most talented, the most intellectual, the highest IQ, or the greatest voices, the greatest preacher, anything, but God just decided to push us. You need God behind.
Lord, help us, sister, out. This in-depth discussion can be yours in its entirety on audio or videotape when you write to us. Visit our website or call 1-800-BISHOP-2.
I want every
LaBelle.
Always.
Also featuring Shirley Murdoch, Helen Baylor, and many more leading ladies of song. This message and music will inspire you in many ways. Move out of the shadows into the light of God's leading ladies. Call 1-800-BISHOP-2 to order.
Don't let anybody fool you. What you don't know can hurt you.
With my husband on our balcony.
And Zarita Jews are found only on this cruise.
You're sharing something, a part of your life, and all of a sudden, you're either being the strength for someone or the encouragement, or they are.
To find out how you can cruise with the Bishop November 9th through the 16th, write to us, visit our website, or call 1-800-247-1899 today.
Helen Baylor, it must be wonderful to be Helen Baylor. Your CDs and singing and traveling all over the world. Has the light that you had in your life often produced heat, and have you ever been afraid to walk into the light because of the heat that it produced?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Even now, I'm just getting to a place where I'm delivered from what folks think about the light that God has graced me with.
Mm-hmm.
But for a long time, I would hang my head. I wouldn't look into the faces of my sisters and brothers in Christ. The only time you would know that God was with me was when I was up there singing. And then afterwards, everything else would come back, you know, and I would hang my head and I would be concerned about what folks thought. And I would be embarrassed of the light, you know, of having the grace and the anointing to sing and to make records. I'd be almost apologetic about it. But now I've grown and I've come to a place where my head is up high. It's almost a new person. I'm getting to know myself all over. Because I'm starting to take what the Word says about me and redefine what I think of me.
You're right.
And it's totally different from the perception that others have of me that they try to put on you. Like, they think you should be a certain way, and if you're not, something's wrong with you. There's a judgment thing. I've gotten rid of all of that in the last, I would say, 18 months or so. I've been born again, again.
Yeah, born again, again. You know, so, that's good. That's so, a good thing.
Be born.
That's a very biblical thing. That's a very biblical thing. Paul said in Galatians, my little children, in whom I travail in birth again until Christ be formed in you. He said, I'm going through a whole new laboring process until the Christ that saved you begins to be formed in you. It's a difference between being saved and having that Christ, that Christology formed and developed in you in such a progressive way. Dr. Cook, is obviously down through your life there's been opportunities and challenges, and from academics and school to being lots of heat.
Yeah.
As a woman in ministry, as a woman in college, as a woman pursuing academics, and then to end up being the president of the Hampton Ministerial Conference. At different stages in your life, how did you deal with the heat, or how are you dealing with the heat? And share, I know you're very, very motivational. You've written several books on motivation. Motivate some women who are shivering in the shadows, intimidated, and yet pregnant with destiny. How do we get them out of the shadows into the light of what God has for them?
You're so right, Bishop. I ended ministry, Mainline Baptist Church, when it was not popular at all. So there was heat coming from every side. And every level the Lord ascends you, the intensity, you know, gets in more intensified.
Mm-hmm.
So people wonder, how do you make it? And it is a combination of, one, knowing that you are God's woman and that God has a purpose for your life, and never really losing that focus. And keeping yourself encouraged, that scripture, David encouraged himself in the Lord. Understanding there's some days a lot of people will not cheer you on, but you have to work for the applause of heaven.
Right.
And not for the applause of others. Yes. And saying, I'm going to do this, and I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Surrounding yourself with family, whether that's biological or extended family, who really are going to love you unconditionally. Allow you to not always be on the stage, and who are going to make sure at home that you're accountable. You know, my family used to say, look, I'm not your pastor's aide. Go get your own water. You know? Kind of keeping the balance, keeping it real. I had to go get my own water. I was like, okay, and keeping that in check.
Okay.
you know, and then going out sometimes and doing some things and not just only church, and making sure that there's balance in my life at all times. So we take wonderful vacations as a family. We don't lose our salvation.
Mm-hmm.
We make sure that we take wonderful vacations and play, because it's important not just to pray, but also to play.
Mm-hmm.
And making sure that I have that play. I'm sitting next to Vickie, and she laughs. You know, she's always animated. And I love it, and that's what I really have to work at, because you have to walk alone many times, and people don't understand. You have a fear of the loneliness, because God is calling you to another place, and hoping that others understand that, but even if they don't, understanding that you are God's woman, and walking in the confidence that the God who called you shall also bring it to completion, that what he has begun in you.
You know something, that's a wonderful thing. One of the things that I want to pull out of you, There used to be a song out years ago, I can't remember who sang it, said it's a man's world.
Yeah.
Okay, you remember the song?
Mm-hmm.
And who was it?
James Brown?
Okay.
Yeah.
I can't remember who it was. back in the olden days. And you found yourself rising up into a career that traditionally had been thought of as a man's world,
mm-hmm.
in a denomination that traditionally is thought of as a man's world.
Yeah.
There are women watching right now who are moving into corporate positions that have traditionally been a man's world.
Mm-hmm.
How does a woman move into what society might say is a man's world, mm-hmm. maintain her femininity, mm-hmm. and keep moving forward?
Mm-hmm. Elizabeth Northcliffe has a book, Play Like a Man, Win Like a Woman. And so understanding the culture that you're coming into, I've always been tall and I've always been athletic. So that's worked to my advantage because I understood team playing, play basketball in 9th and 10th grade because I was as tall as the guys. But those guys also became my boyfriend. So understanding I was female in the midst of it.
So that's how you play like a man and win like a woman?
Okay.
Wow.
You begin to say, not looking at it as a negative, the attributes you have, but saying, okay, my height can, you know, work for me. Mm-hmm. Being able to look in the eyes of a man and not hold your head down, and understanding the culture that you're in, and understand surrounding yourself with women, having village mothers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I make sure that I have 1, 2, or 3, or 4 at all times. You know, sometimes they're in my biological family, but as the women age in my family, now I have to have some other women who can also advise me. Making sure that I'm surrounding myself with women who have walked the walk, who are also leaders. And they may not always be leaders in the church, but a leader is a leader. And they've had to open some doors that I have to go through still. So really taking the advice and counsel, praying, really having a prayer life, like Paula said in an earlier show, just even if you can carve out 15 minutes, but making sure that you have that time. So for me now as a mother and a wife and a pastor, that means in the morning after 7:30, trying to get my kids to school, helping to make sure my husband gets off to work confidently, and then maybe coming home and taking a half an hour just for myself before I go into the office.
Mm-hmm.
But knowing that when I walk out the door that I feel that God is with me, that I am in God, so that when I enter my office and then all the other things that are going to happen that day, that I really have God's hand upon me, that he's got my back, he's my rod and my staff, and that in the midst of enemies, and there will be many,
right.
That he has prepared a table for me. So I really feel that anointing of God at all times.
Are enemies normal? Hey, go ahead and clap. You can clap. Would you say that for a woman moving into new territories that she should expect, without developing a chip on her shoulder, to have some adversity and some enemies? And how do you deal with enemies who are predisposed to prejudices based on your gender or your color or whatever it is?
Enemies are real, and you have more at every level that the Lord has sent you to. You were preaching one day, I don't even know if you were in the anointing, and you turned around and you said, the level that the Lord's getting ready to take you to, be prepared, because the assassins are waiting to attack you.
Mm-hmm.
Before I got home the next day, it had been one of those letters circulating that was negative, and you're like, oh, I didn't know it was going to happen this fast. Thank
right.
you, Bishop. Thank
right.
you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
But enemies are real. In fact, sometimes they seem to outweigh your friends.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but you have friends for a season who help you through that season. And that you're not going to always have the girlfriend you had from high school, because the Lord is allowing you to grow. But knowing that for that season, the Lord is going to put in your life exactly who you need, so that as your enemies come, you also have the advice and counsel of people who are your friends and who have wisdom. So really being prepared, enemies are real. Spiritual warfare is real. And the more that you're in arenas that are new and fresh, people become jealous.
Yes.
And they disguise it in all kinds of ways, but they're jealous. And so they try to attack you. And so the enemies are going to form, as Isaiah 54 says, but God didn't give them any permission. So the weapons will not, that are formed against you will not prosper at all.
That's
and knowing
right.
that,
that's
knowing
right.
that.
God bless you. It's been a privilege to have this opportunity to share the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ with you in so many different and unique ways. It's been wonderful to glean the wisdom and the understanding that these women have shared with you, and I trust you've been blessed.